Hi guys, long time no see. It's me, Kathy, also known as Minister of Style, and I am back with another video. I know, no apologies, but not because I don't feel that you guys deserve one. It's just, I don't really have a really, really great excuse other than I've just let other things take precedence. And for that, I do apologize. I've gotten quite a few new subscribers in the last month or so, and I'm so grateful to you guys for joining my family. I appreciate it so much. I am working on some new stuff. I am 2 weeks, I'm less than 2 weeks away from my next cruise. I'm excited, which is why I'm here to do a video. I am going to have this sweater on in all of them because I'm gonna try to pump these videos out back to back while I'm home alone and it's quiet and I don't have to keep redoing them over and over again because the kids are making noise. So forgive me if you see this video, if you see this sweater in another video. So I'm not gonna talk your head off. Thank you for being here. And today's video is traveling with a child with special needs. A lot of people ask me, how do I do it? Why do I do it? So I'll do the why first. I do the why because I'm a single parent. I enjoy traveling. I traveled solo prior to having children. I traveled while I was married with my ex-husband and our children. And I don't see any reason why I shouldn't continue to travel now that I'm a single parent. I want my daughter to have every experience that any other child would have. And I think that travel is so important that it broadens your horizons and it opens up your world. And especially because she has special needs, I feel that that's extremely important for her to see the world as a bigger place than what she sees on a daily basis. And I also think this is really important for the world to see her. You know, people have this a lot of misconceptions about people with special needs. And the more we keep them hidden away and we don't bring them out into the open and let other people see our children, they are never going to dispel these notions because they don't have anything to base them from. So I want her to see the world and I want the world to see her. That is why we travel. Is it easy? No, it's not. It is filled with a lot of tension, a lot of apprehension, but I still feel it's important and that's why I do it. So the first thing I would say traveling with a child with special needs is what I say traveling with anyone, including just you. Plan, 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 and plan some more. Especially when you're traveling with children, especially when you're traveling with a child that has special needs. You have to take the most minute details into consideration because there are so many variables and there are so many things that are unknown traveling with a child with special needs. A lot of children who have special needs have idiosyncrasies that we don't always understand. Even as parents, my daughter is 9 years old. She has Down syndrome. I'm thinking that she may also have autism. I haven't tested her for that yet, but I'm in the process of doing that. So I don't always know how she's gonna react to things until she reacts to them. Traveling is fairly new in that aspect as she's older now. When she was a baby, it was very easy to travel with her because she was portable and I could just carry her on, put her in a stroller. Now that she's walking around, it is a little bit more difficult. It can be dangerous, but I still think it's worth it. So you have to plan. You have to plan everything from your travel to even little things about how they will react to travel because we want them to have a positive experience, but because it's something new and unknown to them, it may not be as positive to them as we think it is to us. So those type of things have to be taken into consideration. It goes in with those idiosyncrasies. Little things like my daughter doesn't like bushes. If she gets next to a bush, she will completely have a meltdown and you will be wondering what in the world is going on. It's because a bush is there. So I have to do things like make sure I don't let her walk near a bush. I walk on that side where there may be a bush, which may sometimes put her like on the outside and people will say, oh, well, why are you walking on the inside while your daughter's on the outside? Because my daughter is scared of bushes. That's why. Little things like that. Prejudices that people have that they really, and judgments that they really don't understand why you do some of the things that you do. So planning is extremely important when you're traveling with a child with special needs. The first time she flew where she was aware that she was flying was last year in March when we went back home to New Jersey to visit. So I started preparing her by talking about planes a lot and showing her planes. We live near a naval air base where planes are flying ahead above all the time. So I started pointing the planes out to her. I started showing her books that had planes in them and talking to her about planes so that when we got to the airport and she actually got on a plane, she would feel comfortable, and she did wonderfully. She put her headphones on, she watched her movies, and she was just perfect. The only issue I had with her was the fact that she doesn't like headphones and I had to force her to wear them. But the flight itself, she did great. She had no problems with ear pressure because while she doesn't really know how to chew gum, I had her suck on a lollipop. Everything was good. So plan, plan, plan. Leave no stone unturned. Don't feel that you are micromanaging, that you are scheduling too tight. Traveling with a child with special needs, there is no such thing as scheduling too tight and micromanaging. You have to do it in order to ensure your peace of mind and to give them the most positive experience that they can have. And then the second thing is going to seem like it's a little counterproductive from what I just said, but go with the flow. So what do I mean by go with the flow? You've planned, you've planned, you've planned. You've left no stone unturned. But even the best plans sometimes don't go according to plan. And that's when you have to have the go with the flow attitude. You just got to roll with it. You have to keep your plan up here, up in your mind, but you also have to look at what's actually happening and just roll with it and figure out how you can still carry your plan out, but tailor it to what's the current circumstances that are happening right now. Things happen. So I don't know any other way to say other than to go with the flow. Even with all your planning, understand that things may not go as planned. Okay, case in point. Our last vacation, when we went home in March, I was going to rent a car so that we can get around without me having to inconvenience any family or friends to take us wherever we needed to go. Got to the airport. It was very late. Got our bags, went to the counter to be able to rent the car, only to find out the plan that I had in place to be able to rent the car, because I didn't read the fine print in the contract. What I was planning on doing, I was not able to do, and I couldn't get things worked out in a timely manner. It's now midnight with two hungry, tired children, and I'm fussing and fighting at the counter of the car rental place until I was like, okay, this is not going to work. We have to do plan B. So I had to make some phone calls to have somebody try to come and pick me up. That wasn't something that could be done at that time. So I had to Uber to where I was going. That was a go with the flow moment, or either sit at the airport all night until the morning, which I was not going to do with two children. So yeah. Go with the flow. And when you're going with the flow, you need to stay calm and you need to stay centered regardless to how stressed you may feel, because your child that has special needs feeds off of your energy. And I'm telling you all of this because it happened and it wasn't a pretty sight, because she was having a meltdown and I was having a meltdown. And the only person who was somewhat calm was my 13-year-old son. And he just was tired and just wanted to go. So he's like, okay, well, look, mom, can we just do something else? And I'm like, yeah, you're right. We need to do something else. So that's when go with the flow finally kicked in. And I was like, okay, yeah, this is what we're going to do. And then the third thing is ask for what you need, which is a huge problem for me. And I will readily admit that. I never want to be a burden to anyone. I never want my child to be a burden on anyone. And so I have this, I can do it by myself attitude. And guess what? You can't do it all by yourself. Sometimes you need help, especially when it's just one of you and two or more, even one child thrown into the mix can, you know, make things a little stressful. Now you're talking about two, and one of those children have special needs. So ask for what you need. I never want to ask for favors or priority status or, you know, and why not? These things are built in to these entities a lot of time. When we went on our cruise, I was able to get priority boarding so that I wouldn't have to stand in line. She is capable of standing in line. Her attention span is very short and she gets very frustrated because she doesn't understand why she has to stand for a prolonged period of time. And then chaos ensues. So I asked for priority boarding and they gave it to me based on what her circumstances were. I didn't want to ask, but I realized that it was necessary in order to ensure her comfort and my sanity. So, same thing with when we flew. We flew Southwest, and Southwest, like most airlines, allows children six and under to board before everyone else. Now she is clearly over 6 years old, but because of the fact that she has special needs, they allowed me to pre-board with her so I could get her comfortable and seated and not have to be caught in the mix of everybody trying to get on the plane and pushing and shoving so that they can get an optimal seat. We've done priority status when we have gone to SeaWorld. They also have programs there where it's not that you jump in front of anyone, you wait the same length of time, but you don't have to stand in line. It's basically like you go, you give them your information, they tell you what time to come back and you come back. So you're waiting the appropriate length of time, but you just don't have to wait in the line. You can stand somewhere else where it would allow your child to be more comfortable. And you can arrange these things prior to your visit by just either calling their customer service or going to their guest services area, because almost every park or facility that you're going to has some type of area to be able to accommodate guests who have disabilities or special needs. So if you need it in any form or fashion, take it. Don't be afraid to ask for what you need. You're not asking because you just want to beat everybody else to the punch. You're asking because your child genuinely needs this. I'm getting priority boarding again on my cruise that I'm going on in a couple of weeks because I need it. She becomes very agitated when she stands in line. And therefore, when she's agitated, I'm agitated. And she also provokes other passengers from time to time. So I have had to get comfortable with asking for what I need when I'm a person that usually doesn't like to ask anyone for anything at all. So there are probably, I am quite certain, so many, many more tips that I could share, but for the life of me right at this moment, I can't think of any more. And since we all know that I love long videos, and my pack with me that's coming up, if not today, tomorrow, is going to be lengthy, because this is going to be a pack with me for a 7-day cruise with 2 children and no laundry facilities available on board. So I'm usually an advocate of the less is more. Not this time. We're going to do a more is more. So I'm going to end this video. Thank you so much for your time. I hope the things that I've shared with you have been helpful, that it will be beneficial. I hope more than anything that you will not allow the fear of the unknown to keep you from traveling with your child, especially your child with special needs. They will grow so much from the exposure of seeing different things in the world, and that you have this opportunity to present that to them. I think my daughter's a better person because of it, and I want you to help your child be a better person because of it as well. So if I can help you in any kind of way to alleviate your fears or give you more tips, please do not hesitate to reach out and contact me and say, hey, you know, I'm struggling with this. Can you help me? I guess the typical housekeeping is that I would love you to be a part of my family. So subscribe if you like what I'm saying and if you want to hear more of that. I'm not going to ask you to hit the notification bell, because we all know that those things are a little nerve-wracking to be constantly notified every time someone uploads a video. But I can definitely tell you that I will be uploading at least 2 more videos within the next couple of days so that you can look out for them. Once again, I thank you so much for joining me this evening, and I hope you have a wonderful rest of the evening and a wonderful week. Bye.